Hey, what's up guys, and welcome back to Anime King 3, and today I'm going to be giving you part 8 of What If Naruto Had the Most Powerful Sharingan. Remember to get this one to 100 likes as usual, share this to all of your friends in your social media platform, and also guys, go ahead and check out a brand new episode on this channel of What If Naruto Was From All the Clans and Was Taken by Obito. And enjoy that, guys. And also, over on Anime King, I post a brand new episode of What If Naruto Learned Black Magic from a Powerful Spirit. So go ahead and enjoy that, guys. And also, over Anime King, I post a brand new episode of Anime King 2 of What If Naruto Was Banished to the Forbidden Land. So go ahead and enjoy that, guys. And remember, if you're new, to go ahead and click that red subscribe button and become a part of the Anime King family. And thank you for all of your help and support. And yeah, without further ado, what do you say begin this new episode? Start the intro. So the last time we left off, Naruto had a horrible dream. His dream consists of him standing in a deserted Konoha, bodies littered everywhere as he watched the person that did it, and that person was him. All that hate, all that rage, all that power that he's been holding back for all these years, it manifested in a dark, wicked half of himself that was killing everyone as he snapped to swim his neck right in front of him. As he told him that he would not be denied, and he cannot be subdued, he will rise once again. As Naruto tried to fight it off, but he was consumed by all that before he jumped out of bed. As Naruto was panting hard, cold sweat all over his forehead, he hadn't end things politely with Tasumi. The both of them hadn't end things on good terms. Well, it's not like he wanted to end things, but he kind of went a bit overboard. The next morning, she was pissed off when she saw him, as she wanted to kill him. In fact, she did attack him. She ended up punching him, causing him to bleed, as she sat right on top of him and punched him and punched him and punched him, until she broke down in tears. We then had a flashback of Naruto telling her to leave, that he wanted nothing to do with her or the child. But it was a big mistake on his part. His mind was just conflicted with hearing that he was not going to be a father. And all the things that he had done, all the things that he has tried to be covering up for the past couple of years, they were now coming back to the surface, and he lashed out at her. The person that he never wanted to lash out against, because through it all, she has been here trying to cheer him up, trying to be there for him in his darkest times. As she sat there and listened to him, she gave him benefit of the doubt. As he explained everything, he apologized over and over, but she was still pissed off as she told him to get his shit together. She also noticed that he could barely see her. It was like his eyes were glassy. He had not implanted his sister's Sharingan in his eyes. He still had her eyes sealed away, but he thought that he was deserving of his punishment, so he did not implant them. But she spoke to him for a long time. Now knowing that he was going to be a father, he had to get his act together. He had to do something about this. He had to get his head straight as he went to Inuichi. Inuichi was happy that Naruto came to him for him to finally sort out his problems and finally get back on track to the man that he was, even though it's going to be a long, hard, difficult road. But he was glad that Naruto was coming to him now. So they sat down and they talked. Sometime later, he returned back to Tsutsumi, as she hadn't seen him come back the other day, so she thought that he had run away. As he apologized for making her think so lowly of him because he had done so much terrible things. As he was making up for it by being incredibly nice and offering to take her to the hospital. As they went there and they met up with Tsunade. Naruto had known Dan when he was younger, so he had been there for Tsunade while she went through her grief. She was now the person in charge of the hospital, training new medics. Perhaps it was a way for her to get over the stress of knowing that she lost the two most important persons in her life. She just dived into work head on. She was shocked when she found out that Naruto was having kids with Tsuzume. While she didn't expect this, but perhaps this was a way that would help him change. Help him overcome what has been plaguing him for the entire time. The both of them had grief and gone drinking many times to clear their mind of the people that they loved, the loved ones that they lost. And perhaps this will help him. Perhaps this will finally make him be the man that he once was. As he would have to get his head on straight to be there for these children. Children, because there were two of them. She was pregnant with twins. That sent Tsuzume for a loop as she was shot by that. As she had to sit down. Twins. They went home that day as they talked about their respective clans after all. With her parents passing on, she had got the head of the clan. But Naruto was at Uchiha. So that would have some backlash on their part. But Naruto told her that he would handle it. So, she wasn't too worried because knowing who he was, she wasn't worried. But they were wondering when they should tell people, as Naruto was respecting her privacy first, to not tell anyone until she was ready. As she was worried about her friendship with Kushina and several others, knowing that she had done this, but she did not regret it, knowing that she was going to have two children. She always wanted a family. The only thing that was stopping her was because she never found the right person, but she believed that it was him. He was a person for her. So yeah guys, it's basically let's put it off. You guys can switch across the place for yourself. So what do you say we get into this new episode? Let's get in guys. This is preposterous. Fukaku, did you know anything about this? Ask one of the head council members. Fukaku was the head of the Uchiha clan, but they had a council just like almost every other clan. Advisors that they spoke to. The council didn't have much power like the Council of Konoha, but they still were a big voice in the clan. And when certain decisions that had to deal with the head member of the clan, the council would take over if the head member was unable to speak or elaborate on certain decisions. At the moment, no, they were discussing the fact about Naruto being the father of Tsuzume's children. The group was rather shocked by that. Mikoto was in there as well, as Naruto hadn't told her. As he had told her to come to the meeting, she was confused why he wanted her to come to a meeting like that. Usually Fukaku handle all the problems there. But she decided to come along, just for his sake to see what was going on. But she was silent on the fact that Naruto was going to be a father, and with Tsuzume of all person. As she just sat there, not saying a single word. "No, I did not," said Fukaku, as he looked towards other members. The members of the council did not like this. Usually, for the more subdued Uchiha that they had full control over, they had the right to marry them off into certain clans to gain power, or if they found someone else outside the clan they want to be with. But there were certain precautions that had to be made in case they ever had children, because the child would either be born a Uchiha or a part of said other clan. But if they had a Sharingan, they were indeed a Uchiha. And that always created problem for them. As Naruto was sitting there rather calmly, as the old fossils bicker about this and that, there is only one way to resolve this. These children must be brought over to the Uchiha clan and resides as Uchiha's the moment they awaken their Sharingan. If not, no. The group paused at that. As Fukaku sighed as he knew that this would happen, Naruto never really get along with the council. Given that they never really get along with him when he was younger because he was never full Uchiha, he was half Uzumaki. But he didn't really care. As Naruto slowly got up to his feet. The reason I came here to speak to Fukaku about this matter is out of mere respect to Naruto that I have for him and the clan. To you people, am I not the same half-breed that doesn't deserve the same right as a full Uchiha? Am I not the same child that is not worthy of the Uchiha name because I did not awaken my Sharingan? Am I not the same child who shouldn't be a part of the clan? All the members were rather silent because they knew that is exactly what they said all those years ago when he was merely a Uzumaki in name after all. He never possessed the Uchiha main prize, and that was the Sharingan. The Uchiha bloodline cannot be watered down and given off to every clan. One of the members said, trying to find a contradiction too. The words of what Naruto said, and it will not, said Naruto. the matriarch of the Inuzuka clan, would definitely have words with us, considering that she is the one who is bearing my children, said Naruto. And unless you want a problem between two said clans to bring up old grudges and feud for something that can easily be solved with a quick solution, I suggest that you be quiet. Many of them grumbled as they wanted to lash out at him, but it was not that they feared him. Because, well, they did in a certain extent, but Naruto would not try to kill them. He would rather leave this clan than kill them, just like his sister did. While his sister was still a Uchiha by name, as she refused to bend to their will, she was a powerful one and many respect her. Exiling Naruto from said clan would be bad for their image, and they wouldn't dare of doing something like that. His reputation still old far and wide, scaring people out in the elemental nation not to screw with the Uchihas. And he was a big representative of their clan, despite his days where he went in a rather isolated mood. And what do you suggest we do? One of the members asks. Until those childs awaken their Sharingan, they will be free to come and go between the Uchiha and the Inuzuka clan. They can keep their both names of Inuzuka and Uchiha. Them being the children of the head matriarch would give the Uchiha clan more power that it has never had before. What do you mean? One of them asks. We all know that the Uchiha clan is currently in problems with the citizens of this village about our unfair treatment, said Naruto. The Inuzuka clan, while brash, they are loved for their kind, gentle ways of how they treat their dogs, not to mention they hold the only pet hospital in the village where all citizens from all over bring their animals to be treated. And once the combination of the two clans are well known, that we two clans stand by each other because of the union that he's going to be bringing with those two children, that will help us shine some love on the Uchiha clan as well. Because we all know that we need it. Danzo will not stop trying to fight us at every turn. Either we kill him, which will start a bigger problem that neither of us want, or we find a way to get our clan back on the right path. So it is up to you. Start an unnecessary problem or make this work, said Naruto. Or either you exile me from this clan, because I will not force my unborn children into a life of this hassle and chaotic statement without even being judged by the world fairly because of the name that they carry. This is a perfect way of sorting out all the problems that we currently have. While the choice mostly belongs to you, Fukaku. You people of the council, what do you have to say on the matter, Naruto asks. Time skip. The council came to their senses, after all. They realized that this would be a boost for their clan, not to mention Fukaku had already spoken that this would be a good help. The Inuzukas, while they were brash and loud, yes, Naruto was right, they had many support and love because they were the only hospital for animals and many people a part of the village. Bring their animals there to know that the two clans bonded. Well, that would bring a sort of peace, a peaceful outlook on the Uchihas, and that was all that Fukaku always wanted. He wanted the people to see his clan as the others, and not to mention this would give his clan more power over the Hayukas. Always claiming to be the top clan of the village is rivalry with Hayashi, but this will give his clan more power. And it will show the unification of two clans with these children that were going to be brought forth. But the problem was not done yet. The moment Naruto got outside, Mikoto roughly grabbed his hand as she started dragging him along. He didn't say anything as he allowed her to drag him. She dragged him and dragged him and dragged him and dragged him and dragged him, bringing him straight to his house even though he was going there anyway. The moment they got inside, she shoved him towards the couch. What? As she walked around the couch, pacing a bit. What? She said once again. And she just kept on pacing, looking back at him. You're gonna have to explain things to me. Why didn't you tell me? You had to let me find out this way with the others? As Naruto looked at her, as he just watched her pace around the room, venting her frustration of not knowing. This was a shocking news. He was going to be a father of two with Tatsumi. The news was, it was shocking to her. She had to calm down after a while, seeing that he wouldn't talk to her until she calmed herself down. Once she did, she sat in the couch. She's really pregnant. Yes, said Naruto. Huh. I can't believe it. You and Tatsumi. Well, I knew that she had a crush on you. You did, said Naruto. Yeah. She always glanced at you or always looked at you strangely. I figure you noticed as well, but because you were a Kushina, you never said anything. After all, think about it. She's been here a lot. She's been trying to cheer you up ever since she found out what happened, and that was a long time ago. But for the safety of our friendship and to not mess up anything, she's stand back and watch everything unfold. Yeah, I found that out recently. As Naruto sighed, are you okay with this news? Asked Mikoto. I mean, this is a lot. You're gonna be a father. It's not like you planned this. While it's a wonderful gift to bring children into the world, it's not like you're ready for this. How are you handling it? Yes, I'm shocked, said Naruto. Who wouldn't be? But I have spoken with her. We have come to an agreement. We were able to find a common ground to sort things out. You two talk, like really talk, because I swear, out of all the things that you have ever done, if you abandon these children, I will never forgive you. I love you and all, but these children, they're family. You know how father treated you, and that was unfair and unjust. But I really hope that you don't become like him and treat your children the same way. That would never happen, said Naruto. I would rather kill myself than become like father, said Naruto. He treated me horribly and I suffered. I would never want my children to experience that said pain. Mikoto sighed in relief. So, you're facing this head on, right? Yes, said Naruto. As I said, I've been thinking about things a lot lately. Trying to make my life better to welcome these children in it. There's a lot of issue and problem I have to sort out. I guess I have a couple of months to do so, until these children are brought into the world. Couple of months. Not really a long time with all the shit that you have to unpack. But I'll be here to help you, she said. After all, I want to be a part of your life, with your children as well. And I don't want you to push me out. After all, Itachi and Sasuke, they're gonna have more new siblings to play with, she said, with a smile on her face. She was also happy that Naruto was seeming to change a bit. It seems like the news of being a father was changing him, which she really liked. She was gonna have the brother back that she always wanted to return. The one that smiled, the one that gave jokes. She would be glad to have that one back. But she would just have to wait and see for now. So, how is she taking this? Well, at first she was shocked. As you said, who wouldn't be? But we spoke. She's more calmer than before, but she's still shocked. Would you mind talking to her? Said Naruto. Know that you know. You might be annoying, but you have some good points. Hey, I'm not annoying. Of course you are, said Naruto. You're annoying, you jerk, she whispered. As Naruto shook his head. He then leaned back. As she then realized something. As she went quiet. I know what you're thinking, said Naruto. Oh, what am I thinking? You're wondering what I'm gonna do regarding Kushina. Or the others. If I'm gonna tell them right away. How do you... Well, that's one of the few things I thought as well. In the earlier days. Kushina. She's gonna be upset about this. She shouldn't be, said Naruto. Yeah, you might believe that, but she will. Naruto, remember, you and her didn't exactly leave off on a good path because you didn't want to leave off on a good path. After all, you were the one that ended things in a rather miserable way. I'm surprised that she stuck with you. through this hellish time. But she did. Now only to find out that you've moved to someone else because she was a problem. What? I didn't say that. That is what she will believe. I mean, think about it. You didn't want to make things work with her. So what do you think she's going to believe? All of a sudden you just change your mind, you want to be with Tatsumi. This is going to cause a problem in their friendship as well. As Naruto sighed. I know that, he said. Mikoto looked towards him as she was not blinking. What's wrong? You're really listening to me, she said. Of course I'm listening to you. Well, usually you would just ignore me. As she was really happy that he was returning back to who he was, but she can think about that another time. I'll help you, she said. I'll be there to comfort her. So things won't be too bad. Thanks, said Naruto. As she nodded, she got to her feet, still shocked at this. You, a father, she said, as she chuckled. As Naruto shook his head once again. Time skip. As Tatsumi, she hadn't left the house that much. The reason being, she was building up the courage to go and talk to Kushina and the others. Mainly Kushina. As she wanted to let her know that she was still her friend. They had been friends for a long time now. And she knew that a small thing could ruin a relationship, a friendship. But this was not exactly small. And maybe it was because she was nervous as well. She hasn't told anyone out of her mouth yet that she was pregnant, anyone of her friends. As the situation just felt a bit awkward, when Naruto's name came up. Yeah, imagine it, I'm pregnant, and Naruto is a father. How would the others take it? But she had to tell them sooner or later. After all, she couldn't have them being told by anyone else, although Naruto promised not to let anyone else know until she was ready, except for the Uchihas, and they wouldn't really tell anyone. Well, Mikoto, he had to talk to her. She heard a knock on her door. As she opened said door to see Naruto standing there. He had a bag in his mouth. He had two in his arms, and one draped over him. As he entered inside, he made his way towards the kitchen as he placed everything down. What are you doing, she said. Oh, Mikoto gave me this book, said Naruto. About what? How to cook, she asked. No, said Naruto as he looked into her cupboard. As he started to cut a few things, before he started to toss them in the bin. Hey, what are you doing? Those things are bad for the baby. Oh, what? Yes. I read all about it last night, said Naruto. So I brought you some new things. Vegetables, fruits, and things that are healthy for your body. To keep yourself fully sustained while you're pregnant, he said. She looked at him. You bought me things? Yeah, said Naruto. I want to make sure that you are doing okay. And that you're eating properly. And I can cook for you from now on. After all, you know that I'm a great cook. She paused as she didn't say anything. Did you speak to your clan? Are we gonna have any problem regarding my children, she asked. Yeah, I spoke to them, said Naruto. They wanted to take them away. She gritted her teeth. But I told them that was a no-no. So they will be speaking to you about alignment of clans between the Inuzakas and the Uchihas. You mean us joining together? Yes, said Naruto. But this is not a marriage or a union, she said. But it does involve two important figures, said Naruto. I'm speaking about the babies, he said. Along with your reputation as being clan head, and not to mention who I am. So I made them agree that nothing childish or stupidness would happen with my children, said Naruto. Unless they want to exile me from their clan. Well, they can't really do anything about it. Wait, you told them that they should exile you if they didn't want to go along with this? Yeah, said Naruto. After all, I want to make sure that you're comfortable with all of this. I don't want to put anything on your shoulders along with the baby, forcing you guys to do anything that you don't want to do. Said Naruto as he kept on packing the cupboards. So, you would risk being exiled so that me and these kids would be okay? Yeah, said Naruto. I mean, I have a lot to make up for. I was such an ass to you. Terrible, really terrible friend, person overall. With what I said. Even now, I still can't believe I said those words to you. I don't know if you will ever forgive me for that. But I'll try my hardest to make sure that you see that I'm trying. And that I will never say those words to you ever again. He glanced towards her as she turned her back. Are you okay? Yeah, I'm fine, she said, wiping her tears. He would risk being exiled for her and these children. He would risk giving up everything for her and these children. Not to mention him coming over here, acting all fatherly like, buying them new food, things to make sure that the babies are okay and that he's okay as well. And offering to cook for her from now on. It brought tears to her eyes rather quickly. As she turned towards him, returning back to her state to make sure he didn't see her crying. If he did, she could blame it on the hormones. So, what did you get me? As Naruto showed her a few of the things that he got her, her eyes started to twitch as none of these was her style. But he told her that he read it in the book, as that just kept on pissing her off because he kept on returning back to the book and the book and the book. She was a mother, she had a good sense on these things already, but some of these things she didn't know. As she couldn't believe it, this was actually working. It was, and it was great. Time skip. As Naruto, Mikoto, and Tsunade came to a decision. As it would be better if Naruto talked to Kushina first, by himself. Yes. He had to explain a few things to her. To make it didn't seem like she was the problem in all of this. So it was best if he talked to her first. So that is the reason. As Kushina was surprised. It was midday. Kushina received the call that Naruto was at the front gate. As she was shocked. She then remembered their little talk. When she told him that he could let her in. They could still be friends. That she still wanted to be a part of his life. She wondered if he changed his mind. And if that is what the reason that brings him here today. So that is why she made her way downstairs. As she saw him sat in there waiting for her. She instantly saw the look. He looked nervous. And she wondered if that was the reason. As she strutted her way down the stairs. Naruto, she said. As he looked up towards her. Kushina. As he gave her a smile. Kushina was caught off guard. As she never expected him to smile. As he greeted her rather warmly. It lightened her spirits. Come, she said. As she motioned for him to come inside. So he did. As Naruto entered. I'm surprised that you came. So, what's up? She asked. Can we sit? Said Naruto. Yeah, sure. As he sat down at the table. Kushina. I've never hated you, said Naruto. That caught her a bit off guard. What was he gonna be elaborating to her? As her mind went through several scenarios. No, you wouldn't. She had to wait and see, as she decided not to jump to conclusion. I think it's time I tell you why. I made you hate me. Well, I tried to. Kushina, we both know what I did. We both know the lives that I ended to end this war. We both know how many innocents I took down to end the third Great Shinobi War. To make sure it will never happen again, I became a monster. She didn't say anything as she listened to him, as she knew that was true. He had slaughtered countless. He had just erased them, like they never existed. He killed them without a shred of mercy, without a care in the world. But despite that, she was always there for him. She wanted to help him overcome that because she knew after the war it must be affecting him badly. When his mind got all cleared. Kushina, I realized that a monster like me don't deserve your love. She still didn't say anything, and she wanted to hear what he fully had to say. I realized that I never deserved your love. That if you were going to be happy and move on in your life, I only see one path. And that was to take myself out of the equation. You wanted to be there for me, you wanted to help me, but I wanted to make you hate me, so I did everything possible. The way I treated you, the way I acted like a complete jackass, putting you through all that hell. But despite that, you've been there, until I pushed you over the edge. By saying I hate you, and I never wanted to be with you, said Naruto. It was a lie. I know I hurt you badly. And I know, if you don't want to forgive me, you don't have to. But I am truly sorry. I believe that you deserve better than me. As Kushina got up, before she whacked him across the head, "Ow," said Naruto, as she glared down at him. "You jackass. That is why you treat me so badly, because I deserve better. I was willing to help you. I was willing to stand by your side despite everything." She was getting a bit ticked off. She took several deep breaths. "But as I said before, that is in the past. So tell me, why are you here?" As she wanted to know the reason. Was he here to win her back? Her mind was so conflicted, she was with Minato now. She couldn't do that to Minato after all that he's been through with her, helping her to get back on the right track. "This had nothing to do with you," said Naruto. "It was all about me and my problems. And after I hurt you so badly, I thought I didn't deserve to have happiness with you anymore, so I let you go," said Naruto. "So, what are you trying to say?" she asks. "Tasumi is pregnant with my children," said Naruto. As Kushina stood there, completely frozen, she did not make a single sound or move. She just sat there, unblinking. It took her a while. "Tasumi is pregnant?" "Yes," said Naruto. "With my children. We're having twins." "Oh, you two were dating?" "No," said Naruto. "It was a spur of the moment thing that brought this on. But I know what it feels like to have a father that is not there. So I'm willing to stay with her to make this work. I wanted to come here and talk to you personally because, knowing how much I hurt you, I don't want you to think that this is because of you. This was all me," said Naruto. "This is my fault. My problem to bear. But you had nothing to not deserve everything that you wished for," said Naruto. "But once I hurt you, I believe I was not worthy of you anymore. And for that, I'm truly sorry for hurting you," said Naruto. "So, she's pregnant," said Kushina once again. "Yes," said Naruto. "And it's your children." As Naruto nodded. "Oh." As she got to her feet. Okay, she said. As she started to walk away, before she turned back. "So, anything else?" she asks. "Kushina, are you okay?" "Yes, I'm fine." "Well, why would you think I'm fine?" she said. "So, anything else?" "Kushina, Naruto, I'm fine," she said. "I mean, we've been broken up for a long time now. It's not like I expect you to be coming back to win me back. Me and Minato are happily together. And after all he's done for me, picking me back up after you nearly destroyed me for being such an asshole to me," she said, her tone getting a bit hard. "So, it's not like I expect anything from you. It's just, I'm happy. I mean, you're gonna be a father. You remember you and I talking about you being a father many times before. I know how happy you are at the prospect. I know that you would never abandon a child. So I'm happy for you, really. I'm really happy for you," she said, with a big smile on her face. "I hope you and Tasumi have a wonderful life together. I have some things to do. I'll try and go and see Tasumi later on so we can talk. I don't want her to think that this is gonna ruin our relationship or anything like that. So I'll talk to her and get everything straightened out." As she walked over and placed both hands on his shoulder, As for you, Naruto, I'm happy for you. I'm happy that you're finally going to be a father now. So, as I was saying, I have something to do. So, you know the way, you can let yourself out, she said. As she didn't give him a second to say anything as she left. Naruto sighed, knowing that she was not taking it well. Not well at all. But how could he solve this? He heard the door slam upstairs. He knew that she didn't want to talk to him. Now it's best if he just back off until she came to him to talk to him. Maybe let her anger out on him. Which she is rightfully in her terms to do, and he would not try to stop her. After all the hell he's put her through. Time skip. How did it go? Asked Tesume. As Naruto stood in front of her, with a grim look on his face as he shook his head. As Tesume figured that something like this might happen, especially when Naruto explained himself, she would be hurt. As Tesume got to her feet, as Naruto glanced towards her, I'll talk to her, she said. Time skip. Kushina still couldn't believe what she had heard as she sat on her bed in her bedroom. Everything around her seemed to be moving as a blur. As she just sat there, her mind conflicted. Her mind felt like it was attacking her. Several thoughts running through her mind that she couldn't control. She thought that she was over this. She thought that she had moved on. But hearing this, why did it make her feel this way? So much anger. And also sadness as well. But she was so angry. And after he told her about the reason why he was such an ass to her. Because he felt like she deserved better. When all along she wanted to be there for him. And now, Tesume? And she went quiet, lying down in the bed, until she was notified she had another guest. At first, she thought that it was Naruto, so she asked, but it was a woman. She slowly got up as she proceeded to make her way downstairs. Upon arriving, she saw Tesume sitting down, waiting for her. She paused at the staircase, not moving as her mind went through various thoughts, just looking at the woman, until she released a sigh as she made her way down there. As Tesume turned when she saw her, you know, usually I would come here and say that we fight so that we can sort this whole thing out. But that wouldn't be a good idea now, said Tesume, as she tried to play things off cool. But Kushina just looked at her without saying anything. So she spoke once again. I guess you're pissed. Why should I be? Said Kushina. I mean, I've moved on. I'm with Minato now. So of course, I'm not pissed, she said. You certainly don't look okay. And what's that supposed to mean? Kushina, we've been friends for a long time. And I know that it's bothering you. So go ahead. Shout at me. Scream at me for being an ungrateful friend. For going behind your back. As Kushina looked at her, before she came over and sat down. As I was saying, I'm with Minato now. It wouldn't be right for me to curse at you. After all, me and Naruto left a long time ago. Although, I'm surprised that this happened, but I have no right to intervene. Kushina, you know if you bottle your feelings like this, you're gonna end up resenting me and Naruto. I said, I'm fine. Look, it was just surprise that it caught me off guard. I'm guessing Naruto told you what happened. He did. And I said, it was just surprising. It caught me off guard because I never expected this. But I can assure you I'm fine. There's nothing for you to worry about. I know you probably thought that I would blow up or curse at you for something like that, but as I said, I know that eventually he would move on. After all, I did first. And I'm with Minato now. So, there is no reason for me to be mad at you. But you're still not happy with the situation, are you? Well, no, not really. But what can I do about it? You two are going to be having a child together. And despite everything, you're my friend. And I wish nothing but happy for you. I know that you wanted this for a long time. but you just couldn't find the right person. So I'm glad that you found someone. It's a good thing, after all, you won't be so lonely anymore. As Kushner chuckled, it's a good thing that you got pregnant on the first try. What's that supposed to mean? Say Tatsumi. Oh, I'm merely saying. Then know that you're pregnant, he can stay with you. And you will have someone in your life to be with. As Tatsumi's gaze narrowed. Look, Kushner. I know you're upset. But try to make me feel bad. Than I already do for doing this behind your back. It's not going to help anyone. Who said I was trying to make you feel bad? I'm just merely stating that. You have the opportunity to be with Naruto now. Because I know. I know that you liked him in the past. But I never said anything because. You were a good friend. Standing aside and not interfering. Or, said Tatsumi. Oh, I didn't mean like that. No, I think you did. I know that you're upset. I know that I went behind your back. Without even talking to you first, even though you two have been not seeing each other for the past couple of years, and not to mention that you're with Minato. So, for that, I am sorry. But don't. Don't do this. Don't do what? I'm merely stating that you have someone now. And now with these babies coming along, you can make him stay with you. So you think that is the only reason why he would stay with me? Said Tatsumi. No, but it's just everything is okay now. Tatsumi got to her feet. I'll be going, she said. What? I thought you came here to talk. I have to leave now before you say something that you will regret or that I will regret. I know things are rocky right now, but we can still save this friendship. But I'll be leaving. I don't want us to go any further. Because you're trying to make me angry, but I'm gonna keep my cool, said Tatsumi. As she walked away, leaving Kushner there, who simply turned her head as she left. But Kushner did not care. Yes, she was angry. She was furious. The thought was tearing away at her. She tried her best, her hardest, to make him happy. And he said that she deserved better than him, then he had to go and hook up with someone like Tatsumi of all people. And she went along with it as well. Screw the both of them, she got to her feet as she made her way back upstairs. She went towards the gate guards as she didn't want any interruptions anymore. Anyone that came, turned them away. She just wanted to be alone. Time skipped as Naruto sat in the house. He heard the front door slam rather roughly. As he went to check it out as he saw Tatsumi entering, she was taking several deep calming breaths. What's wrong? Said Naruto. She's pissing me off, she said, clenching her fists. She's trying to get at me. She's trying to make me angry, but I refuse. I refuse to get angry at her because I know that I went behind her back and did this, but she has no right to say what she said to me. What? Said Naruto. Tatsumi took several more deep breaths. Know what? Never mind. She's angry right now and you're correct. Let her calm down. Because I'm afraid if things escalate, there will be no point of returning back to what we once were, if there is any point. What did she say to you? Said Naruto. Tatsumi held his hand. It's alright. Let's just forget about it and let her calm down. There are a few others that I'm sure will take the news a lot better than her. It's a good thing that we told her first though. It would have been worse to tell the others before she ever find out. As Naruto nodded. As Tatsumi still looked a bit out of it. Is something else wrong? Said Naruto. She made her way towards the couch as he sat down. As Naruto sat down beside her, and she looked away. If this was only a one-nighter, you wouldn't be offering to be here, would you? She asked. What do you mean? Said Naruto. I mean if there was never the prospect of children, you wouldn't be here, would you? She asked him. No, said Naruto. As she paused at that, let me finish, said Naruto. I would not, because I would still be a wreck. A complete wreck. And there would be no fixing for me. So far. You're the reason why I've started to go to Inuichi for therapy. You're the reason why. I have started to involve myself in deeper clan matters regarding the future of the Uchiha. You're the reason why. I'm looking forward to be a father. It's all because of you. If that never happened, if this never happened, I would just keep on blowing everyone off and sunk deeper into a more seclusive isolation state. But now, I have something else to look forward to. Not just these children, but you, Senruto. I really am sorry for all I did, for the way I pushed you away. I'm just now realizing that you were always there for me, and yet I always just pushed you away no matter what, because I just want to be alone, but perhaps that was not the right answer. As Senruto gave her a smile, she couldn't look at him, as his smile was so bright, and because he rarely smiled nowadays, it affected her a bit. "Thanks," she said, "for sticking through this with me," as Naruto placed a hand on hers as she smiled back towards him, showing off a bit of her canines. Time skip. As Inoichi looked around, along with Choza, as he saw its plate of hot wings coming over, as he started to dive into it, Shikaku sighed as he drank some of his sake, as Shibe was sitting down there as well. All of the members were here, as they were wondering what was going on. "Is this some kind of prank?" said Shikaku as he looked around. "I mean, you said that Naruto was the one that called us all here, right? So where is he?" As Inoichi has not told him that Naruto has been taking third possessions with him, client confidentiality and all, so he would not tell anyone unless Naruto was there to give him the word to give them to go ahead. So odd then that he would not. "I'm sure that this is not a prank. I don't know what is going on either, but I'm sure he will be here soon enough." As they all waited, it was then that Naruto came in. As they saw him, something about him looked awfully different. They couldn't put their fingers on it, as Naruto sat down. "Thanks for the wings, Naruto," said Choza, as he did not order this, but that came to the table, for him especially. And sake had came for the other guys, as Naruto knew what they like after all, especially Choza. "No mention it," said Naruto as he sat back. "So, Naruto," said Shibe, "what exactly is going on?" "I have some news," said Naruto, "and I think I should inform you guys." "And what news is that?" said Shikaku. "Well, I'm gonna be a father." The group paused, everyone taking a sudden stop, as no one said anything for a few seconds. Inoichi didn't even know about this, as he was the first one to speak. "Well, that's surprising," he said. "It's logical that this would have happened, but it is still most indeed surprising," said Shibe. "Yes, it is surprising," said Choza. "But trust me, Naruto, being a father is great. Having a young one to look after and knowing that it's your son or daughter. I assure you, once you get the feeling of fatherhood, you will understand what I mean exactly." "It's sometimes troublesome," said Shikaku. "But he's right. But still, we're surprised that you're going to be a father. We didn't even know that you were dating someone. Even that we rarely meet up nowadays," said Naruto. "With you. And that's my fault," said Naruto. That surprised the group, as Naruto was different. No, he was returning back to normal. "Oh, and it's not just one," said Naruto. "It's two." "Wow. No, that's surprising. On your first shot, being a father of two. Huh, what next? Are you going to tell us that Tsumi is the mother next?" said Inoichi, as Naruto glanced toward the man. "It seems you have gotten a lot better at your mind reading techniques." As the group paused and looked at him with a shocked look on their face. "Wait, are you... what?" said Choza, his eyes widening. Meanwhile, that was going on. "You're pregnant," as Hitomi Hayuga looked towards Tsumi. As she nodded, "Twins, actually." "Wow, The wife of Inui just sat there, and she couldn't believe what she was hearing. As the group of females looked towards her, with a shocked expression on their faces. "We didn't expect this. I mean, we didn't even know that you were going out with someone. Was this a spur of the moment thing or what?" "Wait until you hear who the father is," said Mikoto. "Wait, who is it?" And she mumbled something. "What? We didn't hear that. I said it's Naruto." The group paused as he looked at her to see if she was joking or not. But she was completely serious. Time skip. Later that night, as Naruto and Tatsumi were sitting in the park, as they had just come from telling their friends. "So, the girls took it well. I told them that we spoke to Kushina, but they're happy for me. That is what I was looking for, just like how your sister was happy for me. What about you?" "Well, they were shocked, and not to mention they also want to talk to you as well, it seems. They didn't expect this at all." "Well, no one did, but it turns out for the better," she said. She trembled a bit as Naruto took off his coat, as he placed it on her, as she leaned into it. "You know, just because I'm pregnant, I'm not some defenseless lamb or something like that. I'm still a Jonin and the matriarch of the Inuzaka clan," she said. "Of course I know that," said Naruto. "Yeah, I just wanted to remember that, and everyone else, that I'm still a badass. And I'm gonna be a badass mom," she said, as Naruto chuckled a bit. "What's so funny?" she asked. "Huh, I can already imagine the kids running around, acting exactly like you. I believe they will gain your personality," said Naruto. "That wild, savage side of Mina Inuzaka. It is just gonna make them cute," said Naruto, as he thought about his little babies. "Yeah, Inuzaka babies are awesome," she said. "And they're gonna be a lot awesome. After all, we're gonna be parents. I know we're not used to this, and that we're new at this, but I'm glad that you're taking the time to help me out and all. Tatsumi, as I told you, I messed up badly before," said Naruto. "But I will try my hardest to make up for that." "You're already doing it," she said, with a smile on her face, as she leaned her head on his shoulder. Meanwhile, that was going on. Something was watching the group as it was attached to the ground. It couldn't even be sensed. It was like a part of nature itself. With that, it sunk back into the ground as it quickly made its way. It was a white zetsu. It was one of the saplings that was planted to keep an eye on Naruto. And it had some news that it wants to inform to its leader. A distance away, it finally arrived. The masked man stood there, his back turned, as he relayed the information to the masked man, the white zetsu telling him everything that he heard. The masked man dismissed him as he stood there, removing said mask. This was good. This was the opportunity that he was looking for. Naruto was regaining hope. He was regaining what he was. And if that happened, he would be a more difficult force to handle, because he would be fighting for that woman and his children. But if said woman and children were to be taken away, leaving him broken, just like how he was with the death of his best friend and his sister, well, he was sure that he could convince him to come over to his side. And then he could enact his plan. Minato, or no one else within Konoha, would be able to stop him. Because Naruto would want peace on Earth. He would want a world where he can be with the ones he loves, illusion or not. The masked man smiled to himself. This was the opportunity that he has been looking for the entire time. And he will not waste said opportunity. It was time that he strike. He warned him. Now, he'll have to make sure that he's not found. To make it look like a tragic accident. A ninja from another village. Finding out and knowing and hating Naruto coming for revenge. The masked man chuckled to himself. Things were going to be playing right into his palm. It was time that he reintroduced the world to the devil of Konoha. After all, he couldn't have him going soft. As he smirked at that. But guys, in the end, episode right here. If you want to see the next part, then do like, subscribe, comment down below, and turn on that bell notification as they posted. Remember, share to all of your friends and your social media platform. And also, guys, stay in tune for their stories coming your way over Anime King and over on Anime King 2. That's right, I indeed have three channels, Anime King, Anime King 2, and Anime King 3, which I post what if on every single day for guys to enjoy. So go ahead and click that red subscribe button to become part of the Anime King family. And thank you for all of your help and your support. Remember to comment down below and tell me if you're new. I'll be replying talking back to all of you. So yeah, without further ado, I'm out for now. See you guys soon. Peace.